Hello everyone. So I hope you all had your dinner. All are sitting comfortably in your pajamas. So I'm just checking, want to interact with you all. I'm just taking a very small lecture, 30 minutes lecture, sitting in my bedroom, and I thought that although our major lectures in dams and many of them are over, so but our journey is not over yet. So I planned that let's interact. Let's in sometimes in between we can learn and revise the concepts which we have already did in our lectures. So this lecture will be just for 30 minutes. Remember, pharmacokinetic is a very big topic. But we will try to compile each and everything in just 30 minutes, half an hour only. Okay? We will try to compile everything in just 30 minutes only. So you should not take this lecture very seriously or something like this. Just relax. Just relax and just enjoy this lecture. Try to enjoy it. Try to learn this thing. Learn. Just have a thing in your mind that I am learning a new thing. So if you don't want, you can make notes, and if you don't want, it's perfectly fine. Okay. So now we will be starting with the pharmacokinetics. Although it's a big topic, we will try to finish in 30 minutes only. Okay. And it's a very beautiful topic, a very conceptual topic. You will enjoy it. You will really learn. You will really appreciate that how beautiful our medical science is. So it's just like, you can say, classical song when you put your earplugs and you enjoy a song. Similarly, the pharmacokinetic is just एक गाना है. ओके, सो लेट्स वी विल डिस्कस दैट थिंग इन दैट वे ओनली. वी विल टेक वी विल मेक अ स्टोरी ऑफ इट एंड वी विल ट्राई टू फिनिश दिस लेक्चर वेरी रैपिडली इन 30 मिनट्स. बट एट द एंड ऑफ द लेक्चर आई एम श्योर दैट यू विल एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल द कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ फार्माकोकाइनेटिक्स. ओके, दैट आई विल मेक श्योर. ओके, चलिए. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. आवर टाइम इज ऑलरेडी 10. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी मोर टाइम, हाफ एन आवर समझते हैं, अच्छे से याद करते हैं, एक नई चीज सीखते हैं. ओके, सो लेट्स लर्न अ न्यू थिंग. ओके, लेट्स लर्न अ न्यू थिंग. सो आई विल बी राइटिंग फ्यू थिंग्स. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट, यू कैन राइट. इट विल हेल्प यू अलॉट. सो वट यू मीन बाय द वर्ड फार्माकोकाइनेटिक? रिमेंबर, फार्मा मीन्स ड्रग. Pharma means drug, and if you remember 11th and 12th, kinetic. Kinetic means movement. So it is movement of a drug inside the body. So what is pharmacokinetic? It is the movement of a drug inside the body. Now, just imagine you have taken a drug orally. Can we say when you take a drug orally, it will get absorbed, it will cross certain barriers, and it will come into the blood? So that first parameter, when you take a drug orally and it will cross cell membrane barrier and it will come into the blood. This parameter is known as absorption. So we will write each and everything absorption. So जब हम ड्रग ओरली खाते हैं, सेल्स को क्रॉस करके ब्लड में आ जाता है, इसे हम एब्जॉर्प्शन बोलते हैं. Now when the drug comes into the blood, it reaches to the heart, and when it reaches to the heart, the heart will distribute this drug to the whole body. Agreed? So this second parameter, now the drug will be distributed to the whole body. Second part is known as distribution. Now this drug is a foreign substance for us. Oh my God, it's a foreign substance. What the body will try to do? The body will try to eliminate this drug. It will try to eliminate this drug out of the body. But there are certain drugs which are very notorious, whose chemical nature is just like that they don't want to get eliminated out of the body. कई ड्रग ऐसे होते हैं बाहर नहीं निकलना चाहते. So there are certain drugs which don't want to get eliminated out of the body. So elimination. So उन ड्रग के साथ क्या करें? Let's change their chemical nature. Let's change their personality. So that change of chemical nature of a drug is known as metabolism. And why we do metabolism of a drug? So that a drug can be eliminated. Okay? That is why pharmacokinetic is also known as ADME study. Okay. Pharmacokinetic is also known as ADME study, absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination. Okay. Now, let's discuss each of this parameter one by one. So let's start with absorption. But before starting absorption, keep 2-3 points in your mind. When we will discuss absorption, we will encounter a term known as BA. BA will be bioavailability. जब हम absorption पढ़ते हैं तब हमें एक term पढ़नी होती है bioavailability. So when we learn absorption, we learn a term bioavailability. Similarly, when we will be discussing distribution of a drug, we will encounter a term known as VD. VD will be volume of distribution, that we will write later on. And similarly, when we will encounter the term metabolism and elimination, when we will learn this concept, we will encounter a term CL. CL will be clearance of a drug. Okay. CL will be clearance of a drug. So when we will discuss absorption, BA, when we will discuss distribution, VD, volume of distribution, metabolism and elimination, clearance. Now these three terms are known as primary pharmacokinetic, I'm using the short form for pharmacokinetic parameters. Okay, so these three terms are known as primary pharmacokinetic parameters. So what are the three primary pharmacokinetic parameters? These three. Now, from this parameter, we will derive a term. We will derive one thing known as half-life of a drug. So we will make the formula later on. Half-life of a drug is, just write for a moment, I will explain you later, VD upon CL. That means it has been derived from volume of distribution and clearance. So can we say, first MCQ which comes commonly in your question, is half-life of a drug a primary pharmacokinetic parameter? Is half-life of a drug a primary pharmacokinetic parameter? No, it is rather a derivative of primary pharmacokinetic parameter. Hence, this half-life is rather known as secondary pharmacokinetic parameter. Why? Because it has been derived from primary parameters. Okay, so this is the first slide. Now we will be discussing these four parameters: absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination in just 20 to 25 minutes. Let's see how. So we will make a diagram, beautiful diagram. Okay, beautiful diagram. Okay, so let's start with the first part, absorption. Now, what is the definition of absorption? We will write, definition of absorption is a cellular barriers a drug has to cross. Barriers a drug has to cross to reach systemic circulation. Drug ko barriers cross karne. So a barrier a drug has to cross to reach systemic circulation is known as absorption of a drug. Now, what do you mean by the word systemic circulation? In pharma, systemic circulation means veins. We have to make this drug enter into veins, because if a drug will enter into veins, it will reach to the heart. So this is what we meant by systemic circulation. So systemic circulation ka matlab, the drug, how much drug will come into the veins. So let's make a diagram for it. Sir, suppose this is a vein. This is a vein, and we have to make this drug reach to the vein, and this is heart. Okay, this is heart. So can we say a drug has to cross certain barriers? This is a barrier. So the first thing which we have to learn in absorption is, what are these barriers? For what are these barriers? You have to learn one thing, by what route we give a drug, route of drug administration. So the first thing you have to learn in pharmacokinetic is routes of drug administration, first thing. And second thing you have to learn in absorption is that after crossing this barrier, the drug will come into the blood. But sir, how much drug will come into the blood? How much drug that will come into the blood after crossing a barrier is known as bioavailability. So we will write the definition of bioavailability later on. Okay, so you have to learn two things in absorption. One, the route of administration. Second, after crossing all these barriers, how much drug is finally reaching into the veins or to the heart is known as bioavailability of a drug. That this much amount of drug is available in our body. As simple as that. I hope you have understood this simple point. So let's start with first point, that is route of drug administration. So let's start first with route of drug administration, and we will write here only. Routes of drug administration. Okay, so we will write that there are mainly two routes. The first one is enteral route, and the second one is parenteral route. Apart from enteral, all other routes are known as parenteral routes. So two routes are there. Now enteral means a GIT. So the first route is through GIT, and in enteral route, the first route you will write is oral. The first route you will write is oral route. Okay. Now, when you give a drug orally, orally means the drug will absorb from either stomach and small intestine. And remember, most of the drugs, they get absorbed from small intestine because of all drugs, or you will write all drugs, they absorb from small intestine mainly because of the greater surface area. Okay. Now, suppose this is stomach and this is small intestine. You have taken a drug orally. Okay. You have taken a drug orally. The drug will cross these cellular barriers, and the drug will come into first a vein known as portal vein. I am writing a short form for that, portal vein. Now remember, this portal vein does not drain to the heart. This portal vein first drains to the liver. It first drains to the liver, and from liver, it drains into heart through inferior vena cava. It drains into the heart through inferior vena cava. So don't you think, before a drug can reach into systemic circulation, this liver will degrade the drug or metabolize the drug? So can we say that in oral route, a drug undergoes, a very commonly asked question, a drug undergoes first pass metabolism in liver. First pass metabolism in liver. So this is a very frequently asked question. So it's a very frequently asked question. Please mark it. Because when you give a drug from stomach and small intestine, it will first go to the liver. Can we say that this first pass metabolism is before occurring, a drug can reach into systemic circulation? Drug systemic circulation mein aane se pehle hi liver degrade kar raha hai. Hence it is also known as pre matlab pehle, systemic circulation mein aane se pehle, metabolism, that means we are degrading or changing the chemical nature of a drug. The drug is useless for us now. Okay, so in which route the drug undergoes first pass metabolism? Oral route, first MCQ. Second point, now what are the other routes by which we can give a drug? So you will write sublingual or buccal. Now in sublingual route or buccal route, you place a drug below tongue. And below tongue, remember, you have superior vena cava, and this superior vena cava directly drains to the heart. This superior vena cava directly drains to the heart. Is there any liver coming in? Is there any liver coming in between? Kya beech mein liver aa raha hai? In this whole way or road, is you are seeing any liver? No. We are not saving any liver. Similarly, the third route is rectal route. Now in rectal route, you will write, we give a drug into rectum, and through rectum, a drug will come into external hemorrhoidal vein. External hemorrhoidal vein. And external hemorrhoidal vein drains into inferior vena cava. External hemorrhoidal vein drains into, it's a direct tributary of inferior vena cava. Do you think the liver is coming in this pathway also? No, liver is not coming. Hence, can we say that these two routes, they avoid or bypass the first pass metabolism of liver. So sublingual route and rectal route, they bypass the first pass metabolism of liver. Okay, now let's talk about parenteral roots. Okay, parenteral roots. Parenteral means apart from GIT. So apart from GIT, all roots are known as parenteral roots. So there are certain injections. So I have told you this was the vein. This is the heart. Okay, so the first route is IV route. In IV route, you give a drug directly into a vein. You give a drug directly into a vein. Okay, can you tell me that if you are giving a drug IV, if you are giving a drug IV, and let's say you are giving 100 milligram of a drug, how much drug will come into the blood? Can we say even 100 milligram will directly come into the blood? Because in IV route, there is no barrier a drug has to cross. So tell me, bachcha log, tell me the answer. Bachcha log, tell me the answer. What is the bioavailability of IV route? What is the bioavailability of IV route? The bioavailability of IV route is 100% because there is no cell membrane barrier. There is no barrier a drug has to cross. Hence, IV route has 100% bioavailability. Now, above this, make a muscle. Inject a drug into muscle, IM. Above this muscle, we have subcutaneous fat. We have subcutaneous fat. So we give a drug into subcutaneous fat. And above this subcutaneous fat, we have skin. And skin has dermis. So we can give a drug intradermally, ID. So what we have written? IV into a vein. Above a vein, we have a muscle, intramuscular injection. Above muscle, we have subcutaneous fat, subcutaneous injection. And between subcutaneous fat and epidermis, we have intradermal injections. And above the skin, if you are giving a drug, you can apply a patch. So this patch is known as transdermal patch. So by all this route, the drug will finally come into vein. The drug will finally come into the veins. Okay. The drug will finally come into the veins. Okay. Now, one MCQ you will write that intramuscular injection can lead to staining. It says stain ho jati hai muscles and subcutaneous fat. So you give intramuscular injection by Z technique. Just write this word, Z technique. Z technique is given for intramuscular injection. We make a zigzag skin so that staining doesn't occur. Okay. So this is all the routes of drug administration. Now let's see. Finally, the amount of drug that enters into the blood is known as bioavailability. So finally, after crossing, the drug that finally is entering into a vein is known as bioavailability. Now the point is, what is the definition? Bioavailability is the fraction. Suppose you are giving 100 milligram of the drug and finally after crossing a barrier, only 20 milligram of the drug is coming. So what is bioavailability? It's a fraction of drug that reaches systemic circulation. So 100 diya, 20 aya. This is simply bioavailability. Now, can you tell me bioavailability of IV drugs? Sir, IV drugs to hum directly vein mein dete hain. We directly give a drug into vein. There is no cell membrane barrier. So bioavailability of IV drug is 100%. Because of this reason, it is taken as a standard. It is taken as a standard. And now we will calculate the bioavailability of all other drugs. So how we can find it out? Very simple. How do we find out bioavailability? Let's measure this plasma concentration of a drug. Let's measure this plasma concentration of a drug. So I have written plasma concentration. But can we say the drug which is coming into the blood will come with time? Wo achanak to nahi aayega, dheere dheere aayega. So we calculate bioavailability with time. Itna drug, itne time mein blood mein aa gaya. So IV drugs, they have 100% bioavailability. Rest all other routes, they have less than 100% absorption or bioavailability. So how do we calculate bioavailability? So we make a graph. Let's make a graph for it. Concentration, time graph. Can we say this is the total amount of drug which is coming into the blood with time? This is the total amount of the drug which is coming into the blood with time. This whole graph, let's call this area as AUC. AUC stands for area under curve. So this is the total amount of drug which is coming into the blood with time. So bioavailability is area under curve of concentration time graph when you have given a drug by some route, let's say oral route or any other route. Oral route or any other route, any route, divided by area under curve of concentration time graph when you have given a drug IV. And IV you will write always IV. Why we are taking IV as a standard? Because IV drug will have 100% bioavailability. All other routes will have less than absorption, less absorption into the blood. So all other routes will have less bioavailability. And now we can say that if 100 diya, 20 aya, so 20% is the bioavailability or 0.2 is the bioavailability. So can we say the symbol of bioavailability is F? F means fraction. Now on this graph, just tell me, I have given two drugs to our patient. This is drug A, this is drug B. Okay. Now, can we say this is time, this is concentration, and this A is coming into the blood maximum at this time, B is coming maximum in this time. Let's call that parameter as Tmax. Isko hum Tmax bol dete. Bachcho batao that on this concentration time graph, which drug is coming rapidly into the blood? Which drug is coming rapidly into the blood? Jaldi kaun aa raha hai blood mein? A jaldi aa raha hai because its Tmax is slow. So on this area under curve or concentration time graph, Tmax, it tells you about the rate or speed of absorption. This is an MCQ. So when you calculate bioavailability, you also calculate Tmax. And Tmax tells you about the rate of absorption. Agree? Maza aa raha hai? Okay, samajh aa raha hai? So you don't have to write anything, just understand this part. So this is about absorption. Next parameter was distribution. Now finally, from heart, the drug has entered into veins. So now, went to the heart. Now the drug is pumped by the heart to the whole body. So now the drug will be distributed to the whole body. So I am coming to that diagram only. So this diagram we have made. Okay, this diagram we had made. So I am now extended this diagram. So here the absorption part is over. A for absorption part is over. Now I am telling you the distribution part. Now when this drug enters into the blood, it has two options. Okay, either it will remain in the blood or it will move out of a blood vessel and it will deposit in organs. This is the second thing which can happen. Either the drug will remain in the blood or it will get deposited in the organ. And if this organ is the target organ, the drug will produce its beneficial effect or therapeutic effect. But if this organ is unwanted organ where this drug should not go, bachcha log tell me what the drug will produce. The drug will produce side effect or adverse effect. So how we can find whether this drug remains in the blood or it deposits in organ, it moves out of a blood vessel. We calculate this thing by a parameter known as VD. VD stands for volume of distribution. And volume of distribution or VD in one word means extravascular deposition of drug in organs. Okay. If a drug is moving out of a blood vessel more, the drug will have high VD. High VD drug means the drug is in organs. The drug is moving out of a blood vessel. So how we calculate VD? It's very simple. Dose given. By which route would you like to give dose? IV. Why? Because now we don't want to calculate absorption. Divided by plasma concentration measured. Okay. Dose you give in milligram. Plasma concentration you measure in milligram per liter. Hence, ml and mg will cut. The units of volume is liters. Now, bachcho log, just tell me one point. If plasma concentration of a drug is less, can we say the drug is moving more into the organs? Yes, the drug is moving more into the organ. And if the drug is moving more into the organ, the drug will have high volume of distribution, because volume of distribution means more drug is moving into the organ. So decrease in plasma concentration, it means the drug is moving out of a blood vessel and it is getting deposited in a blood vessel. So less plasma concentration, it means the drug is moving out of a blood vessel. Now, how do we calculate VD? We have calculated VD on what factors volume of distribution depends. Very simple. If a drug is lipid soluble, this drug will go and deposit in fats, because fats are also lipid soluble. So first point is lipophilicity or lipid solubility increases volume of distribution. Okay. Second point, in our plasma, we have big plasma proteins. So if a drug is bound to plasma protein, can we say that these plasma protein will not allow a drug to move outside? Yes. So increase in plasma protein binding decreases volume of distribution. So plasma protein binding reduces volume of distribution. Simple. And among them, the major determining factor is plasma protein binding, because lipid soluble drug can also bind to plasma protein. And there are two types of plasma protein. One is albumin and second is alpha-1 acid glycoprotein. Albumin binds to acidic drugs, because albumin itself is a basic plasma protein, and here acid word is coming, so it itself is an acidic plasma protein, so it will bind to basic drugs. So all basic drugs will bind to alpha-1 acid glycoprotein. So if I'll ask you a question, aspirin will bind to, aspirin is acetyl salicylic acid, it will bind to albumin. All natural drugs which are found in nature, like morphine, quinine, they all are found in nature. Atropine, strychnine, all these plant products, remember, are alkaloid. What do you mean by the word alkaloid? Alkaline. Alkaline means basic. Basic means any natural drug is generally a basic molecule. So any natural drug is a basic molecule, alkaloid. Alkaloid means alkaline. Alkaline means basic. They will bind to alpha-1 acid glycoprotein. Now, just remember this point, that volume of distribution changes in disease conditions like nephrotic syndrome. Can you tell me, bachcha log, why? Cirrhosis of liver, CHF, etc. Why? Because there is albumin loss in nephrotic syndrome. Albumin nahi hoga blood mein. More drug will move out of a blood vessel. In cirrhosis, both these proteins are not synthesized. Okay? CHF, the plasma will leak out of a blood vessel. So volume of distribution changes in disease conditions. Agree? Let's move ahead. Let's now move forward. The third parameter is metabolism. Okay? So finally, the drug which is present in the blood will now come to the liver, because the most common site of metabolism is liver. And what is the definition of metabolism? Metabolism means a lipid soluble drug after metabolism, M for metabolism, will be converted into water soluble. A lipid soluble drug must be converted into water soluble molecule. Why, bachcha log? Because only a water soluble drug can be eliminated or excreted out of the body. because all our secretions are watery secretions like urine, sweat, saliva, milk. So only a water soluble drug gets eliminated outside. So lipid soluble drugs are also known as non-polar drug. To convert a non-polar drug into polar molecule is known as metabolism. This is the definition of metabolism. Most common site is liver. Now two things happens in metabolism. When you are changing this nature of a drug, when you are changing this chemical nature of a drug, what will happen to the activity of a drug? The first thing which can happen is one inactive drug can be converted after into one active drug after metabolism gets converted into inactive form, and the action of this drug is over. And this happens with most of the drugs. But the second thing which can happen is one inactive drug after changing its chemical nature can be converted into active form. Okay. And the third thing what can happen is one active drug after metabolism can form another active metabolite or another active form. So these three things can happen when you are changing the chemical nature of a drug. Now, bachcha log, remember one point, mark this line. Inactive drug after metabolism are getting converted into active form. So this second one are known as prodrugs. So what are prodrugs? Prodrugs are inactive drug after metabolism, they get converted into active form. Is point number three a prodrug? No, point number three is not a prodrug. Prodrug must be inactive drug. Now the second thing we have to learn, is how does this chemical reaction occurs? What is the mechanism? Kaise hote hain? Very simple. Suppose this is a lipid soluble drug. What we will do, first point, we will break this lipid soluble drug into smaller molecule. And after this smaller molecule, we will attach a water soluble group. Now we will link a water soluble group to this molecule. So this is how this chemical reaction occurs. So in liver, there are two types of chemical reaction occur. First is phase one reaction. Can we say that phase one reaction are catabolic reaction? We are breaking this drug into smaller molecule. And after this thing, phase two reaction occurs. In phase two reaction, we are attaching or linking or conjugating a water soluble group. The drug will become water soluble. So phase two reaction are known as conjugation reaction. So question comes, in which reaction we link a water soluble group? How will we link a water soluble group? Phase two reaction. Examples, how to identify whether the reaction is phase one or phase two? If you find any word in which we are linking something, this is phase two. If I say acetylation, we are linking acetyl group. Glucuronidation, we are linking a group. Methylation, we are linking methyl group. Phase two reaction. So let's write phase two reaction. You will write glucuronidation. Glucuronide laga do. Okay. Glycine laga do. Glutathione laga do. Any group, you don't have to remember their name. Methylation, acetylation. So all these reactions in which we are attaching some group is phase two reaction. But if I say there is a reaction known as oxidation, reduction, dehydrogenation, deamination, we are not linking anything. So those reactions are phase one reaction. When you are not linking anything, those are known as phase one reaction, like oxidation, reduction, okay, dehydrogenation, deamination. So you are removing something, you are not attaching something, cyclization, decyclization, etc. Okay. Now, one question comes, what is the most common phase one reaction? The most common phase one reaction is oxidation reduction. And the most common phase two reaction is glucuronide conjugation. Which enzyme does? oxidation and reduction are carried out by CYP450 enzymes. Which enzymes? CYP450 enzymes. And glucuronide conjugation is carried out by an enzyme which is deficient in Krigler-Nasr syndrome, UDPGT, uridine diphosphate glucuronyl transferase. And the last point we will write with them is that where do they occur? Remember, all phase 1 reaction, they occur in liver. In liver, they occur in microsomes. So they are microsomal. Microsomal means that they occur in SER. All phase 2 reaction are non-microsomal. That means they occur outside SER. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. They may occur in cytoplasm, nucleus, mitochondria, etc. Except one point. Which phase 2 reaction is microsomal? Only microsomal phase 2 reaction is glucuronide conjugation. And this is an important MCQ. Okay. This is an important MCQ. So this is about metabolism. Let's come to now elimination. So the most common site of metabolism was liver. The most common site of elimination is urine or kidney. The most common site of elimination is urine or kidney. So finally, the drug which is coming to the kidney and the drug is going to the kidney and this is now getting eliminated out in urine. But apart from urine, you know any other body secretion, the drug can be eliminated out in that body secretion. Okay. In that body secretion, like sweat, saliva, you know any body secretion, the drug can go there. Tears, milk, bile, you don't have to remember them, okay? Gases which we exhale, okay? Now, here I want to tell you one concept. Sir, the drug you are finding in urine, is known as elimination rate or elimination. It means this much amount of drug came out into the urine in this much amount of time. This is known as elimination. Itna drug itni der mein body ke bahar aa gaya. Rate of removal of drug is known as elimination. Okay. Okay. And this is the concentration of drug in which is present in blood. Now we should not confuse this elimination with a parameter known as clearance. Don't you think, sir, this drug is coming out into the urine, we call it as elimination. But don't you think this kidney will be having some power to remove a drug? So this organ power is known as clearance. Is organ mein kitni taakat hai drug ko bahar nikalne ki, this is known as clearance. How much drug is finally coming outside is known as elimination. So what is clearance? Clearance is the capacity of an organ to eliminate a drug. It is the capacity of an organ to eliminate a drug. So kidney mein kitni power hai? If this clearance capacity is very high, can we say you keep on increasing the dose of a drug, more drug will come outside. Kidney has a very good power. Then this drug will show first order elimination. First order elimination means that if you increase the concentration of a drug, more drug will be eliminated. Okay. But if this clearance capacity is low, can we say if you will keep on increasing the drug, elimination will become saturated. So it will show saturation or zero order kinetics. Now, what is expected from you is examples of the drugs that show saturation or zero order kinetic. Just remember three. The list is very big. There is a mnemonic which I teach in class, WhatsApp. On that WhatsApp mnemonic, you have to remember three molecules: alcohol, ATP, theophylline, and phenytoin. So very few drugs they show zero order kinetics, that is alcohol, phenytoin and theophylline. Now just write one point, that alcohol shows pure zero order kinetic at all dose. It shows pure zero order kinetic, while other drugs in high dose, they show zero order, while in very low dose, when the capacity is not saturated, they show first order kinetics. But which drug shows pure zero order kinetic? Alcohol. So this completes elimination. Just give me now 2 minutes more. Let's make a summary of each and everything. So now I will tell you certain formulas in pharmacokinetics. So please write this part, because this thing you will not get in any of your books, and it will help you solve all the questions of pharmacology. So formulas of pharmacokinetics. So I have already told you about four parameters. Tell me, bachcha log, what were the four parameters? Absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination. So these are the four parameters. Okay. Now, in absorption, which formula we have learned? Bioavailability. First formula, write it in your notes. Area under curve, or you will write concentration of a drug. Let's say when you have given a drug orally, I'm using the oral one. Area under curve or concentration when you have given a drug IV. When you have given a drug IV. And what was the symbol of bioavailability? F. So this is the first formula you have to remember. Second formula, distribution, volume of distribution, that is dose given IV, we have already discussed, upon plasma concentration measured. So this is the second formula you will remember, in distribution. Now from this formula, we will derive two more formulas. From this formula, we will derive two more formula. First formula, VD is equal to dose given oral. Above we have written IV, divided by F and plasma concentration. First formula which we have derived. So you will write number 3. From where we have derived this formula? Sir, F stands for bioavailability. Agree? Yes. And second formula we will write, let's encircle now this part, dose given. Remember, the initial dose which we give is known as loading dose. Loading dose, IV, or initial dose which we give is equal to volume of distribution into concentration, plasma concentration. Which concentration? Target concentration which you want to achieve in your patient. So from here we have derived another formula of loading dose. So you will write fourth formula in pharmacokinetics. Okay, let's talk about now metabolism and elimination. In metabolism and elimination, I will tell you the formula of elimination. Bachcha log, I have just told you elimination is directly proportional to clearance concentration in first order kinetic. I have told you. So just write clearance into target concentration. Okay, clearance into target concentration. Now, bachcha log, we have written 2 points here, target concentration, target concentration. Bachcho, just understand this part. Suppose this is the target concentration you want to achieve in your patient. Okay, this is the target concentration you want to achieve in the patient. To achieve this target concentration, the first dose you give is known as loading dose. Okay, to achieve this target concentration, the dose you give is loading dose. Loading dose depends upon volume of distribution. Now you have already achieved this target concentration. Don't you think after some time the drug will be eliminated outside? The drug will be eliminated outside. And we know the drug will be eliminated, its concentration will fall. Yes. Now you want to maintain this concentration. If you want to maintain this concentration, this is known as maintenance dose. So that this concentration should remain steady. This concentration should remain steady. So this is known as, this target concentration is also known as, this target concentration is also known as steady state concentration, because this concentration we want to maintain always in our patient. Okay. Now, don't you think the amount of drug which is getting eliminated, if we supply this amount of drug from outside, the concentration will remain steady? Yes, concentration fluctuate nahi karegi. So what is maintenance dose? Maintenance dose is nothing. It is opposite of elimination. Jitna drug body ke bahar nikla, the amount of drug which is going out of a body, just supply this drug again from outside, the concentration will not fluctuate, the concentration will be maintained. Maintenance dose and elimination are equal and opposite. So tell me two questions now. The first question is, loading dose depends upon volume of distribution. Maintenance dose depends upon clearance capacity of the body. So this is the fourth and fifth formula you have to remember. Okay. Now the last formula I want to tell you is half-life. Half-life means the time required to make a drug half. Half-life means time required to make a drug half, like this. This is known as half-life. So each is a specific half-life, So every time if a drug requires 2 minutes, so the half-life will be 2 minutes. So time required to reduce the plasma concentration to the half is known as half-life. So this is plasma concentration. Okay. But what will happen to the other drug? This drug will be eliminated. So can you tell me after first half-life, how much drug will be eliminated? 50%. After second half-life, how much drug will be eliminated? 50 plus 25. 75% will be eliminated. After third half-life, how much drug will be eliminated? 50 plus 25 plus 12.5. 87.5. So this we know from our basic maths. Now, what is the formula of half-life? The formula of half-life is 0.0693 volume of distribution upon clearance. Volume of distribution upon clearance. So this is the plasma concentration. This is the drug which is present in organs. And the drug which is coming into the blood is known as VD. Okay, concentration. And this drug is moving out of the body. And that depends upon the organ CL. Can we say that if volume of distribution of a drug is high, the drug will remain in blood for longer duration of time? Half-life will be more. But if the clearance capacity of an organ is high, can we say the drug will be eliminated very easily? In that case, the half-life of a drug will be low because the drug is getting out of a body. Because the drug is going out of the body. Okay, so what is the formula? The formula of half-life is 0.693 volume of distribution upon CL. From where this 0.693 has come? It is log 2. Log 2 means exponential decrease in 50% or half. 2 word is coming. Hai na? So 100 ka 50, 50 ka 25, this is known as log. This is known as exponential decrease. Hence, we apply a value of log. Okay. And this completes our pharmacokinetics. So this is all you have to remember, the concepts in pharmacokinetic. I went very fast with you because it was a simple lecture. No need to understand, no need to write it down. Just have a basic brush up idea that yes, we are recalling each and everything. We have already attended in our class. So it was just a brush up. So thank you very much. So I will not waste any more time. I know that you need to sleep also. So this is all you have to understand in pharmacokinetics. Okay. So thank you very much.